one topic is over. Now what is next question?
Like it came like we told religion that we follow some religion. So it's religion, the moment that we call religion, there is someone who has defined stuff and you have to follow that, something like that. So why one person has to guide other person?
Why you have to go to so your question is why religion is there? Why some religious founder has done something?
Not only religion, something. Why I have to learn something?
Yeah, why you have to learn something is the learning is a part of everything. You cannot discover yourself, no? Everything.
It depends upon what you want to discover.
Yeah. What you want to discover, you don't know. So everything you cannot discover. Let us say today I start discovering science by myself. You cannot do that. It's a long way. So there's no other. Somebody else's learning can be your starting point so that you can learn what is missing. Right? It's like your father, your grandfather. Suppose your grandfather's had a property, it belongs to your father, it comes to you. Now your grandfather struggled for his survival. Okay, it took him, by the time he became 80, he could make some property. But now if the property comes to you, your part of survival question is gone. Now you can see what else I can do. So otherwise you start from the scratch. So like that, there are a lot of things in life. Whether science, technology, cooking. If I want to start from the basics, then it's a long way to go. Okay, so what you tend to do is you'll try to pick up from somebody has done. Pick up from there. The question is whether you pick up from there and get stuck in that, or question is whether you pick up from there and improve on that. We don't know. All right. So religion, what about religion is that a child which is born is innocent. He tends to learn everything from the environment. Everything is learning has to come from environment. Child doesn't come with this. Child may come with some potential, but not actual. What is required? It comes from the social. What I call as collective learning of the society. The collective learning as society has gone over a period of time. It has gone. It has from generation to generation it improves. In fact, your generation to your next generation children, they will learn much more. For them, some things are taken for granted. Okay, the social learning or collective learning gets passed on to them in the form of social media, some other form, so that they don't go to basics. Okay, so generation to generation, the learning curve of the humanity will keep shifting for better or worse. So religion is also lauded as a part of human conditioning, where the humanity has found that, I need to survive. I have a feeling of emptiness inside. So then religion tries to fill up that gap by promoting one more interest called, so there is something higher than what your normal life is, a holistic life, or what you call as holistic life. So by taking up certain principles or certain practices which help you to go to that. So that's what is the promise of a religion. So now all the people who are interested in that, either by nature or by force or by birth, they start accumulating in that religious this thing. Now the people who go to the religion, people who are a part of the religion, they are called followers of certain religion. A follower follows no matter what it means.
He doesn't question.
A follower. And most of the people are happy and comfortable with that. Okay, why they are happy? Because they feel more of a people with like-minded people, interest people. Maybe in the dress, maybe in the way they dress, maybe the way they talk. Typically, these religious groups will have a similar dress code, okay, or similar lifestyle, or similar food habits, or similar prayer places, similar what you call as hangouts. Weekend hangouts where people come out.
So the religion is not any better than a community, currently Facebook community.
It's a special interest group where poetry is worldly. So religion focuses on otherworldly poetry. It's a poetry only. So it focuses on something poetry which is trying to focus on the poetry which is beyond your world. And it addresses a very deep insecurity of people. Okay, what will happen if I die? So that religion promises after you die, nothing will happen to you. You'll go to a very nice place where good 5-star hotels are there. So that type of promise gives some comfort level.
False happiness.
No, you don't know it's false. No, you are actually comforted. You are actually looking for
untested.
So you don't know it's fast or false or this thing. You are looking for comfort level. I can't even say. See, you are feeling insecure.
Why I'm asking you, because men, unlike women, at the age of 45, 50, what I'm seeing now, they believe all this philosophy stuff, and all the moment physical stuff starts receding, they start looking into spiritual stuff. But women are basically more spiritual. That's what I have observed. So why we have to be like that?
No. This word spiritual also is, we have to understand. Okay. What is world spiritual? What is religion? Now, religion is, I am saying, it gives you some comfort in the physical, this life, where you are getting more like-minded people, right? Like-minded, like dressed, like food habits, all right? So, and also it gives a more comfort for you for a marriage or relationship. A person marries from one religious community, he'll feel more comfortable because the dress and all those habits and all is more predictable. No, I can't even say superficial. It's for people, it's a day-to-day living. So that's there. Then it also promises afterlife also. Okay? So whether it's there or not, you don't know. But you tend to start believing, believing for promises because that's the only thing you have. Nobody gives anything better than that. So you start believing that. Whatever is that? So you don't have a choice now. What is the other alternative? Other alternative is not knowing anything. It's uncertainty. So it's a place. And I'm saying the human nature is they want certainty. They want comfort level, right? So somebody gives a promise which seems to be better than being uncertain. So you take it. That's one way. Then second way is there is a fear also. If you don't follow, there's some religions and all where there is a threat. You'll be outcast or you'll be hit or killed. The fear is there. The fear and reward makes you to conform. So that's what religions are built. Right?
So life is all about looking at the safer zones.
Let us take the next question. Women and men are...